Let me remind you that in the last segment I explained how to perform a row reduction of a matrix, which is a process that starts with an arbitrary matrix and produces from it a matrix in reduced echelon form. Now, row reduction was the last element that we needed to complete this diagram, which shows how we can solve systems of linear equations. So this diagram is now finally complete. What I want to do now is to give an example how this method of solving systems of linear equations described by this diagram works in practice. So we will start here with a concrete system of equations. We will put this system through all the steps described by this diagram, and we will find solutions of this system. And so here is the system we will be working with. This is a fairly complicated system of three equations in four variables, and our goal will be to find solutions of this system. Now, the first step in this direction, as we know, is to write the augmented matrix, and you can easily verify that the augmented matrix of this system is this matrix. Next, we need to perform a row reduction of this matrix. This is the most time-consuming step since it involves several operations on matrices, but luckily the augmented matrix we have here is the same matrix that I used in the last segment to explain how row reduction works. So if you want to have a look how to reduce this matrix step by step, you can go back to the last segment and it's done there. But here I will just use the fact that the result of this row reduction is a matrix which looks like this. Now all that remains is to read solutions of the system of equations from this matrix in reduced echelon form. And now for this purpose it would be useful to label columns of this matrix with variables these columns correspond to. And it will be also useful to highlight the entries which are leading ones in this matrix. And now what we see from this reduced matrix is, first of all, that this matrix has no leading one in the last column, the column of constants. Remember that what this means is that this our system of equations is a consistent system, so this is a system that has a solution. The second thing that we see is that there is also no leading one in this reduced matrix in the column corresponding to x3. And this, as we know, means that x3 is a free variable in this system. So now we know not only that the system has a solution, but in fact it has infinitely many solutions. There will be one solution of the system for each value of x3. And now finally, we can write down the solutions of this system. And we again do it using this reduced matrix. The first row of this matrix tells us that 1 times x1 plus 3 times x3 equals to minus 4. And this, in other words, tells us that x1 equals to minus 4 minus 3x3. The second row tells us that 1 times x2 minus 2 times x3 equals to 1, which equivalently means that x2 is equal to 1 plus 2x3. Now, as we have already noticed, x3 is a free variable. And to get the value of x4, we use the last row of this reduced matrix, and this row tells us that x4 is equal to 1. And now we are finished. Our system of equations is solved.